often, I really should check what people send out when they're talking about me. Nothing like trying to live up to that. We shall see what we can achieve. Yes, good afternoon. My name is Ian Cruikshank, and I'm from RateSetter, the UK's leading peer-to-peer lending network. And we are focused very much on how we engage and empower people to make the most of their money, or get most of their money out of it. So we are, before we start, I just want to clarify one thing, is sharing is something I do a lot. It's something I do with my friends, it's something I do with my family. It's something I do via different platforms that are available here today. But it's something I do for free. Now that seems a strange thing for somebody from finance to say, but I think it's important. So I find if I charge my friends, I generally have less friends. So for me, and this is going to sound a little odd at the sharing economy, but the key word is not so much sharing, but economy. I think it's vital that we talk about the impact of the sharing economy on the economy. This is a real economy. As Benita identified, this is a huge and fast growing economy. And it's vitally important that we understand there is money to be made to support this economy. This needs to be a sustainable economy. And for us, people need to be able to make a fair profit to be able to support the sharing that's delivered. So as we have it, I remember what we're talking about. I think this sharing economy is a huge opportunity, not just for businesses, but for individuals. It provides access to opportunities that people never had before. Not that they were denied, it was simply not possible to make this happen. And I think the sharing economy also helps reset the balance of power between corporates and consumers. So I've been asked why RateSetter is supporting the global sharing economy. Well, RateSetter was set up in the heart of the recession, when there was a big need to be filled. There was a need of lenders who just couldn't get a decent return on their money because the high street just wasn't offering it. They got told what you were allowed to have, and if you didn't like it, tough. There was a need from borrowers who couldn't get access to finance on fair and reasonable rates. So there's a massive need where we came in and we decided to bring borrowers and lenders together in a simple and easy manner. So allow them to, a lender to share their money and get a better return from it. Allow borrowers to borrow on fair terms and to be able to do it in a simple and easy manner. And I think we are so keen to support the sharing economy, just as we've disrupted in the finance economy, we are keen to support any sharing economy company in any sector who is looking to disrupt that sector, especially if that sector has forgotten to focus on customer value. At the end of the day, it's all about returning value back to the end consumer, about a fair and equal distribution of the profits within an industry that allow everyone to benefit, not one individual or small 20% to benefit over the others. And I think the future of the sharing economy is closely linked to the strength and the growth of the UK economy. And I'd like to think that the sharing economy will become just a standard norm, what everybody does. And certainly my children are very keen on the sharing economy, not just because I shout at them all the time that they have to share nicely, but also because they will provide them with greater opportunities in the future. It'll also provide a hopefully more stable economy that isn't so reliant on a few. So how are we helping the sharing economy grow? Well, as I said, we simply bring people together. We cut out the banks, which is saving a load of cost, time, energy, and grief often the way, and just allow people to get more from the assets that they have, lenders to get more from their money, and borrowers to get a fairer deal all in. So by cutting out the cost, I think it just provides a bit of a win-win-win situation. It's a win for lenders, it's a win for borrowers, and yes, it is a win for us. It's a small win. We make a very small profit, what we see to be a fair profit. We cut out the costs, we share the savings with both borrowers and lenders, so everybody wins. And I think that's the best way of making this a sustainable business and ultimately how the sharing economy can be a sustainable economy. When everybody wins, it'll grow. So it's proving rather popular at the moment. So we are fairly well established in the peer-to-peer market. We are growing fast, and we've got a forecast of giving out £1.25 billion worth of loans by the end of this year. So it's growing at a massive pace, and with a 98% satisfaction rating, which is pretty unheard of in finance. Not many people say they 98% would support their bank in any way. So we figure that this the sharing aspect, there must be something good about it. So I would just say we're proud to be part of this. It is by delivering value back to customers, they find that quite attractive. That is what the key part of the sharing economy is about for me, and about making a win-win-win for all involved. So thank you very much, Vinny.